Welcome everybody to a 50-pack PTCGO opening of the newest set, Evolving Skies. And I opened a few of these up, but I just got 50 codes from an online store. And we're going to open them and see what we get. So let's crack into the first pack, no more waiting. And no more funny games, see what we get. So for a Rayquaza VMAX, because I already got a Rayquaza V. I just need a VMAX Rayquaza. And we got the Lilligant and the Altaria with the Tempting Tune ability, which is just such a deck for a supporter card, which could be super helpful. But anyway, let's see what we can get. There's Shelagon and a Gyarados VMAX. It's got the Hyper Beam for 120, discarded energy from your opponent's Pokemon, and max Tyrant for 240. This thing's a tank. This thing's just tanky. 330 health as well. Jesus. So we go for this pack. Alright. Thievul. It actually has a good ability, because when you evolve it, it's pretty much just Marnie, which is really good. Look at the Slakoff just hanging there. Look at that. Very adorable. No more interesting card. There's a card, I forgot what it was. Oh, Dracossault V. Primeval Beak? During your opponent's next turn, energy cards can be attached to your opponent's hand to the defending Pokemon. Wow. So I guess if you set up early game, you could just Primeval Beak for 30, and then next turn, Mountain Swing, and Primeval Beak. We could just Primeval Beak for 30 all this time. We also have this as well, which is super strong slash for 300 damage. You have to discard all the energy there. But yeah, there's a card in this set that allows you to essentially just discard stadiums. That's it. It's that easy. Raihan. You can play this card only if any of your Pokemon were knocked out during your opponent's last turn. Attach a basic energy card from your discard pile to one of your Pokemon. If you do, search your deck for a card and put it into your hand. Wow, that is really good. So after you secure a knockout, you can search for a card. And we got Seismitoad as well. Not interested. Sorry, Seismitoad. Not interested. Maybe if you did something else. What's this? Dream Ball. These cards are completely new to me. I've never seen this before because I did not open up the Japanese sets. So you can play this card only if you took it as a face down price card before you put it into your hand. Search a deck for a Pokemon, put it onto your bench. Okay. So it's pretty much just a face down price card thing. And Zinnia's Resolve, also a new card. You can play this card only if you discard two other cards from your hands. Draw a card for each of your opponent's Pokemon in play. Alright, you turn on this deck, so watch out. And a gold metal energy. They're back with the gold energies. I thought they got all the gold energies in Chilling Rain. Huh, it's weird how they're back. But I got a gold energy, a gold metal energy. So I can pimp out my Zacian ADP deck. Which I don't know if I want to use that. We got Gordy as well. I don't know what he does. I got three of them, apparently. But look at the top seven cards of your deck, and you may reveal any number of energy cards you find there and put them into your hand. I thought I was going to say put it onto your Pokemon, but it doesn't, so that's pretty good. And if the Pokemon's card attached to you is in the active spot and is damaged by an attack, you can discard a card from the hand. Okay, interesting. And Lilligant. So the Spirit Masters allows you to discard one of your opponent's cards after attacking, essentially. Ooh, Pyro's in the set. Look at him. Ripclaw, he'll rip you. Rip you to shreds, man. Shopping Center. Once during Stadium Guard, by the way. Once during each player's turn, that player may put a Pokemon tool attached to one of their Pokemon into their hand. Right. Okay. I don't understand why you'll play this when Tool Scrap is a thing. Like, because obviously you want your opponents to be at a lesser advantage than you, so you're not gonna put a stadium in play that they both can use. Treasure energy just does, if you take it from your prize cards, before you put it into your hands, you can attach it to any Pokemon. Alright, and that rare is a Golurk V. Golurk. Rewinds Beam. If your opponent's active Pokemon is an evolved Pokemon, devolve it by putting the highest stage evolution card on it into your opponent's hand. Woo! That's alright. That's nice. That's a good move. When are they going to bring back Devolve Spray? I feel like that was pretty good. Ooh, Elemental Badge. That reminds me of something. I don't know what though. It's just fire, water, and lightning, but I don't know what it means. Whatever. If the Pokemon V this card is attached to has Vaporeon, that's right. We opened it in the Eevee Heroes set. That's right. So if the Pokemon V this card is attached to has Vaporeon, Jolteon, or Flareon in its name, its attack cost. Wow. Okay. So it costs one less. That's actually really cool. And Stoutland. A lot of abilities in this one. Is this just me? As long as this Pokemon is in the active spot, your opponent's active Pokemon do 30 less damage. Yeah, that's kind of pointless. Seeing how Stoutland doesn't really hit for much. Nothing. Ribbon Badge? If the Pokemon V this card is attached to a silver in its name and it's knocked out by damage from an attack, that player takes one fuel prize card. Oh, okay, so you've got Sylveon VMAX, you can attach that and they take one less prize card. Interesting. Flaffy with Dynamotor. Once during a turn, you may attach a Lightning Energy card from your discard pile to one of your bench Pokemon. That's good, but that's actually really good. You don't need to. Another Gyarados VMAX. We got two of them. That's fine. The tank. It's such a tanky card. You know, I would love to play it. I would love to make a deck out of it. If I can get two Gyarados V, I would be happy. And so we got two rares here. We got the Versailles Flapple and a Medicham V, which is my second one, which Yoga Loop is pretty good because if you put two damage counters on one of your opponent's Pokemon, and if you knock it out, you basically get to attack again, which is pretty cool. Smash and Smash Uppercut as well. And Dragon types are back. Dragon types. I forgot to mention, they got this little thing here. I don't really like that little claw marks through there. I just don't. It's not really up my alley. But if it suits you, then go for it. Alright, so Thievul and a Gorgeist with Pandemonium. Reveal the top 6 cards of your deck, and this attack does 60 damage for each psychic Pokemon you find there. So it's kind of like Sandaconda, but instead of energy, you're finding Pokemon and it does damage times the amount of Pokemon you got. That's interesting. Boost Shake. I got two of these, but I did not read it. Search your deck for a card that evolves from one of your Pokemon, put it onto that Pokemon to evolve it, and then shuffle your deck. Then you can use this card during your first turn on a Pokemon. You can, but your turn ends. Oh, okay, that's actually really good. And a Sylveon V! We got our first Eeveelutions. Dream Gift, which says, once during your turn, you may search your deck for an item card, reveal it and put it into your hand, then shuffle your deck. Fuse's ability to turn ends. Interesting. Well, that's fine, because if it's on your first turn, you can use it. And then search for that ribbon badge, and then you take one less prize card. Your opponent takes one less prize card if he knocks you out. Very interesting. Alright, so we got two of these. Bada bing, Drampa, and a Florges with Rapid Strike Connection. As often as you like during your turn, you may move an energy from one of your Pokemon to another one of your Rapid Strike Pokemon. Okay. So we got 33 packs left. I'm sorry if I'm talking too much. I just am very excited about what these cards do, and I like building decks. So. Glaring Articuno. Cruel Charge. When you play this Pokemon from your hand onto your bench during a turn, you may attach up to 2 Psychic Energy cards from your hand to this Pokemon. Ooh, that's interesting. And then Psylaser says, discard all Psychic Energy from this Pokemon. Then this attack does 120 damage. Wow, you can get that. You could do that turn 1. Turn 1 Psylaser for 120 damage. Ooh, that's interesting. That's cool. I like that. Like it a lot. So we've got Gordy again, we've got Avalug, Frost Barrier, Braviary, and a Glacian VMAX with Crystal Veil. Do I have any of the... No, I don't have any of the other ones. That's fine. Crystal Veil. Prevent all damage done to this Pokemon by attacks from your opponent's Pokemon VMAX, except any Glacian VMAX. Wow, so Pokemon VMAX are useless against this unless it's Glacian v Glacian. Glacian or is it Glaceon? I prefer Glacian. I think that sounds just about right. Oh, another V. Garbodor V, which is Trash Stench for 40 damage, and your opponent's active Pokemon is now poisoned. Then during the next turn, the Pokemon can't retreat. And then Sludge Bomb for 130. Right, so I guess if there's a weak Pokemon you want on there, or like something you don't really need, the opponent doesn't really, I don't know, You could just lock them, pretty much, essentially. Sun and Moon badge, what does this do? I got two of them, apparently, but I don't know what this is. If the Pokemon V this card is attached to has Espeon or Umbreon in its name, whenever your opponent plays a supporter card from their hand, prevent all the effects of that card done to that Pokemon. Huh. I wonder what supporter cards would really, like, go for that, you know? I don't know. Duraludon V, our first Dragon type V-Max, which is Skyscraper. And it's prevent all damage done to this Pokemon by attacks from your opponent's Pokemon that have any special energy attached. And then G-Max Pulverization for fucking 220. And then you can use it again. So you can just keep 220ing. And if they've got any special energy, suck shit, essentially. You know what I mean? Like, that's about right. Ooh. Rescue Carrier. Put up to two Pokemon, each with 90 HP or less, from your discard pile into your hand. Oh, interesting. And a Smeargle. Smeargle. Okay, let's see what we've got here. Teddiosa. Oop. And a Lycanroc V. Rock Throw for 40, and then Crashing Fangs for 200. And then during your next turn, you can't attack. I don't like those cards. I don't like during your next turn, you can't attack. I don't like it. That's why I never really was keen on Zacian. Anyway, Stormy Mountains. Once during each player's turn, that player may search the deck for a basic Lightning Pokemon or a basic Dragon Pokemon and put it onto the bench. Then that player shuffles the deck. Interesting. Interesting. I'm pretty sure you can search. Yeah, you could search for that Flaffy. What did that Flaffy do again? I don't know, but it was good. Rapid Strike Scroll of the Flying Dragon. Holy shit. Got Rayquaza around you. So you can use this attack. You can use this attack if it's attached to a Rapid Strike Pokemon and it's Meteor. So discard 2 energy from this Pokemon. Then this attack does 90 damage to one of your opponent's Pokemon. Very nice. I like that a lot. Switching cups as well. Switch a card from your hand with the top card of your deck. And handy. Very handy. Appleton. Thick Mucus and Fighting Tackle. I'm not going to read it because I'm not ever planning on using Appleton in a deck. I got Chincha and another Lycanroc V. Wow. I just want a Rayquaza V-Max. If you can get a Rayquaza V-Max, I'll be happy. An Espeon V. We got three Eeveelutions if you count the V-Max as a Glaceon. Zen Shot. This attack does 60 damage to one of your opponent's Pokemon V. And Psybolt for 120. Interesting. Very good. Full Face Guard, Lombre, Shelgon, Sharpedo, and the Pinsir. Damn. Alright. Digging Gloves. The attacks of the Pokemon this card attached to do 30 more damage to your opponent's active fighting type Pokemon. Interesting. And then Marshadow. The Rapid Hunt and Shadow Flicker. Search a deck for two Rapid Strike cards and yeah, take one more prize card if it's knocked out. Cool. Interesting. Snowleaf badge? What does that do? I got three of them. Oh no, yeah, do we read this before? If this Pokemon V has Leafeon or Glaceon in its name, it has no retreat cost and no weakness. And a Volcarona, our first legendary. Surging Flames, this attack does 20 more damage for each basic energy card in your discard pile. Then shuffle those energy cards back into your deck. Discard energy card from the Pokemon. Cool. I like that a lot. That's could be useful in some fire decks. Like, that's just a good option to have. Moon and Sun Badge. I don't know why you wouldn't just go Sun and Moon Badge. But you have to go Moon and Sun. That just sounds ridiculous. Oh god, look at Pikachu. I got six of these. Energize. Attach a lightning energy coming discard pile to this Pokemon. And then Electric Ball for 30. Jump Off. And then Fluffy Barrage. This Pokemon may attack twice each turn. Ooh. Spinning attack twice. I just realized that Electric Ball will cost 3 energy and hence for 30 damage. They do my boy Pikachu dirty every turn. Except for Vivid Voltage. They really made him shine there. Galarian Moltres. Ooh, nice. Malevolent Charge. Same thing as the Articuno. You know, attach up to two Darkness Energy cards from your hand to this Pokemon when you put it onto your bench. And then Fiery Wrath. This attack does 50 more damage for each prize card your opponent has taken. Good for the late game, but you gotta be careful your opponent doesn't take too many and win. Regidrago. He's in here. I love Regidrago. Dragon Energy for 240 minus. What does that do? This attack does 20 less damage for each damage counter on this Pokemon. Right, so even if it's still doing a fair bit of damage, if it's like, you got that in there. But yeah, 240. That's cool. I like that. That's really awesome. Alright, so we got a reverse holo Pikachu and another Regidrago. A Regidrago deck? Who knows? Oh my god. Alright. Pumpkaboo. And a glaring, we got all the birds. We've got all the birds. I didn't realize that it was a pre-release card. That's cool. Strong legs charge and zapper kick. And it's also a reverse holo. That's awesome. What does that do? So the same thing, attached to two fighting energy cards when you put it onto your bench, and then zapper kick. You may discard all energy from this Pokemon. If you do, your opponent's Pokemon is now parallel. I don't like that. Sorry, for 70, if it did 100 damage, I would like it more. But 70, I feel like it's going to take you a while to get some hits on. And Altaria, which is search a deck for a supporter card. When you evolve it. And a Seismitoad again. Nothing in that pack. Because we can't even use Seismitoad. We can't use Seismitoad. The Dream Ball. And another Medicham. I got three of these bastards. Maybe I have to make a deck around Medicham. And try and, trying to work around that. I don't know. Dialga. It's a holo in this set. Didn't we see Dialga in Vivid Voltage as well? We know he's back in that as a holo. Chrono wins. If the defending Pokemon is a V, it can't attack. And then Heavy Impact for 210. I like that, but a lot of energy. I think it's hard to cycle different types of energy onto one Pokemon. I always find that hard. Another Espeon. Alright, that's fine. I'm happy with that. If you want to give me a VMAX Espeon, that works for me. Let's see what we got. Another Garbodor. Okay. That's cool. It's cool with me. Damn. Shiftry is a darkness type now. When he's usually a leaf type or grass type? That's the question. Pinsir. Where's a Pinsir? I got so many. Vice Coach. Damage from your single strike Pokemon's attacks isn't affected by your opponent's weakness or resistance. That's helpful, actually. I like that a lot. Put that onto your decks. Ribombe. Where's that card that... I'll find the card after I do this. If I don't get it, I'll find the card. Oh! Lycanroc VMAX. He's got a V. I didn't realize he had a V. I didn't know he had a VMAX. All right, guys. I'm sorry for dissing the V. Hunting Claw. Knock out one of your opponent's Pokemon in play that has 60 HP or less remaining. Okay. That's right. Then Max Edge. This stack does 30 damage to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon. I mean, it's not bad. Because you can definitely just do... Do the Hunting Claws and then the other one. Like, you can do 190 and then you can just do something else again. Next turn, you know what I mean? I don't know. I'm just making shit up as I go. I just want to read these abilities. Group Power. If this Pokemon has 3 or more Water Energy attached, it gets plus 150 HP. So it'll have 180 HP. Jeez, and Schooling Shot. And this attack was 31 damage for each basic energy attached to this Pokemon. Okay, wishy-washy coming in. Milotic as well, the Dewgard. Whenever your opponent plays a supporter card from their hands, prevent all effects done to that Pokemon. Wait, prevent all effects of that card done to you or your hand. Right, Marnie is no longer affect you. Which is fine. Do I have any more of these wishy-washies? I would love to make a deck about this. I do have heaps of them. Holy F. Not these ones. This one. These are the ones we want. I got 4 of them. That's going to be a deck. I mark my words, wishy-washy deck list, OP. Not really. Love this card. It's a full art card. I want it. Another glaring Moltres. That's fine. At least we didn't get two glaring Zapdos. But I would love the Articuno. What's this? Bergamot. That evolves into Alvalunch. I don't know his name. Talonflame. As a colorless. Clutch and Nitro Dive. If this Pokemon has any fire energy attached, this attack does 80 more damage. Okay. And it acts freely if a stadium is in play, this Pokemon. What? That's ridiculous. It can't attack. I don't like that at all. We've got two packs remaining. Crystal Cave. Once during each player's turn, that player may heal 30 damage from each of their metal Pokemon and dragon type Pokemon. Wow. Yes! Yes, yes, we got it. We got Espeon VMAX. And he's got an ability. Let's read it out. Solar Revelation. Prevent all effects of attacks from your opponent's Pokemon done to all your Pokemon that have energy attached. Wow. And then, of course, existing effects are not removed and damage is not in effect. Of course. We know that. And Max Mindstorm. This attack does 60 damage for each energy attached to all of your opponent's Pokemon. Oh! Wow. I mean, wow. Wow. I already got an idea for this deck. I got an idea for the Espeon VMAX deck. Now, last pack, it says. I think this is last pack. Avalog, that's his name. Let's see what we can get. Hopefully, something nice. A holo. That's alright. Enthusiastic Dance. When you evolve this Pokemon during a turn, you may use this ability. During this turn, your basic Pokemon's attacks do 100 more damage. We can pair that with the Regidrago, right? We can. I don't have two of them though. I only have one. I need more of these. I need more of these cards. I got one more pack, man. I didn't know. This is our last pack. This is it. A holo Shiftry. And come on, guys. Can we get a drum roll? Ah, that's okay. Tempting tune. I got four of them. But I don't think I'll need to get a supporter card or anything. Anyway, that is it for today. Wait, actually, before we go, I want to show you something. Yes. All right. This is the card that I was talking about, right? And I've got four of them, so it's absolutely amazing. Pumpkaboo with his ability Pumpkin Pit. When you play this Pokemon from your hands onto your bench during a turn, you may discard a stadium in play. So path to the peak, finished. Boom. Gone. Get out of here. Anyway, that's what I wanted to show you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Peace out. Have a good day. Bye.